Hello, beautiful Pisces. How are you today? Welcome to the channel. My name is Donna. I'm so glad to have you with me today. Let's look at the overall energy and the intention for your love reading at this time. So let's see what we have. We have magic, moonlight, enchantment. Ooh, you have some romance coming in, Pisces. What is going on? Okay, we have frog spirit renewal. So you may be in this period of renewal in a present relationship. Looks like it's going to be a romantic time for you. Chaos, storm spirit. All right, so with every bit of sunshine, a little rainy day must come in, or something like that. If you know what that saying is, please leave it in the description box below or leave a comment. Okay, this is a two-part reading. This is a love reading followed by a person of interest, thoughts, feelings, intentions, and actions towards you. So let's get started. Pisces. Romance and chaos. That's sort of an interesting energy. At the bottom of the deck, though, for this love reading, we have the Devil card. Somebody making an offer. Somebody making an offer with strings attached. A feeling of things not going well. So it could be somebody from the past, though. Could be what this storm is about, is an old breakup. Who knows? Okay. So we have Pisces. You're in this very down-to-earth energy, and you are attracting someone who is probably Virgo energy. That is your seventh house on the astrology wheel. So we see you really coming to this conclusion that you want somebody who's very grounded, who doesn't rush things, who moves at a reasonable pace, who's willing to do the work, and you're bringing that energy in also to this love reading. Look at that Sagittarius energy. You may meet somebody new by chance, just out and about in your local neighborhood. It looks as though you're really on the precipice of leaving a stormy time behind. Beautiful. Ooh, the Three of Pentacles, Capricorn energy. You could meet somebody at work. So that's pretty exciting in terms of your collaboration. The reason this card is such a good, positive card for love is we have basically two people, and then, you know, the third entity is the relationship itself when it comes to a couple. In a love reading, it's about two people creating the third entity, which is, you know, could be a child if it's a relationship, quite literally, but it's all about creating a good relationship. So the Two of Cups energy is beautiful. It really speaks to the fact that you are attracting in someone who's very, has qualities, high quality person is what I'm seeing here. The Two of Cups is the Bride and Groom and the Rider-Waite card. It's about being best friends. It's about wanting to go through life together, you know, with somebody that could be very different from you. The Two of Cups is Cancerian energy. Here's Cancerian energy again. Your person's going to come in very quickly towards you. Somebody's riding in. Somebody has a lot to say. Honey, I'm home. This is the Emperor, and the Emperor knows that they have to balance their emotions because those horses are driving that carriage with full force. And this is a very balanced person with a very strong sense of duty and happiness and what comes next, how to be successful. The energy, oh, look at that, an offer coming in, an offer of substance, because when we look at the Ace of Coins, when we have the Three of Cups, it's the engagement ring. The Three of Cups represent the bridesmaids for the wedding. So you have two really strong energies here, along with the, well, these are all really strong energies for relationship and love. The energy is that you are leveling up. You're going to the next level with somebody who's very significant. Strong Taurus energy. Spirit is recommending that you enjoy every part of your relationship with a soulmate. Gemini energy, making a choice. Closing somebody, you know, as one door closes, another opens. And we have Eight of Swords. So Pisces, I see you in the mood with this Eight of Swords energy of saying, you know what, I'm going to, this energy is all about that you're going to let whatever happens unfold, and you are not going to take any overt action towards anyone. That you're just going to stay here blindfolded, sort of like, I'll be over here. If anybody's interested, you come to me. And so that's what's coming up here for you at this time. So let's see what we have for the energy of that Knight of Pentacles. Tell us more about the Knight of Pentacles, please. Okay. What about the Knight of Pentacles for our friends here? We have the Page of Wands. So lots of communication. Somebody who likes to text, who likes to keep in touch. They don't talk too much at the time because Virgos don't have a tendency to spend a lot of time at work texting others, but this person will always keep you in the loop. I like it. Page of Wands energy is throwing caution to the winds. This person wants a victory with you. They want to introduce you to their friends. This is a very public card. It says, you know, I'm going to come. I'm going to make a big display coming towards you. I'm going to make my intentions known. You really are receiving this offer from someone who is very forthright, very honest, somebody who really can bring a lot to the table within your relationship. There we go. The Emperor's driving the chariot. What did I say? So this person is very strategic and they're coming towards you swiftly. The Wheel of Fortune, there we go. Six of Cups. Somebody is, you know, in the mood to buy flowers. Someone's in the mood to make sweet love offerings, bake cookies, knit sweaters, you know, take your dog for a walk. But this person is in it to win it. Ace of Coins again. We have two aces. Aces, like I said, are a substantial love offer. Let's see, we have your person coming in very fast. They want to talk to you. They have a lot to say to you. And when we see anyone carrying the swords and rushing, we know that this person is, they have a truth to speak. They have something that they want to tell you very much. They also want to tell you what they expect. So when we get the, I call it the runs with scissors cards, because sometimes this card is very blunt. Blunt to the point of almost being too blunt. And what this person wants to tell you is that they're not going to be juggled. They've been juggled in the past. I said that they were a kindred spirit to you because we have this energy of chaos. So your person's been through their own chaos and they're not going to put up with any chaos from any new relationships. And you feel the same way. You know, both of you are on the same page. You're both holding. Anytime life becomes chaotic, you're both holding your love in a very protected position with that Two of Cups. You know, everybody else can juggle, they can do whatever they want, but the two of you are very much on the same page with that energy. The Two of Cups here, protecting love, a true love, and the Two of Cups here. So let's see what else we have for the Two of Cups. We have fire in your belly. You both have fire in your belly for each other. A strong element of adventure, of being really willing to do the work. Throw caution to the winds. It's very much about a fire in your belly. Being tired in life overall, having been through the mill with the chaos, but both of you want this beautiful energy of the Venus, of love. You know, when we look at the Empress, she embodies love. The Emperor and the Empress, now we have divine coupledom with a love offer and somebody coming in to do the work straight towards you. So you can sit here all you want, all day long, and you can be assured that there's going to be a ring at the doorbell. Ring literally. The Ace of Swords, again, your person is rushing in. They want the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. You know, when we look at the Ace of Swords, that's all about truth-telling, being honest. And when we look at the Knight of Swords, they're insisting that you know their truth, what they expect, what they want in a relationship, because your person will not suffer any fools. And I don't think you will either, Pisces. You're not up for any foolishness. It's been too tough to get through the last time you had that situation. So we see the Justice card, balance, Libra energy. That is the seventh house of marriage. You know, the Justice card is usually when the the two of you decide to buy a home together, it's usually when you might rent a place together, but it is a legal connection, an obligation in a relationship. We do have the Five of Coins here. You might not be ready for it yet. The Five of Coins may delay that interaction of moving to the next level. Now we have the Chaos card again. So let's get to this Chaos card. What is that Tower card about? It's about making a choice in love. So what I'm seeing for you, Pisces, is that you're not going to really put up with any chaos. You know, at the end of the day, if somebody doesn't choose you for a relationship quickly, that you're going to basically set them outside the door. This is the energy that I get. So anybody who thinks that they can just rush in and offer you less than what you expect, which is a legacy relationship, you're looking for full-term, long-term, and you are not having anything less. The only choice that you will make, Pisces, is one that's going to validate happiness and bring security into your life. Why is the Ace of Coins here? Okay, there we go. Oh, beautiful. The two of you love each other. We get this very nurturing, soft, sweet energy. On the other side of this power couple, we have two people that really love each other, two people who are investing in each other. But that Queen of Cups is, you know, you're on the same page. You'd like to share family life. You want to be comfortable. You want to build a legacy together. And we see the card of, I love it again, the Lover's card is clarifying the Hierophant. You are being divinely protected with this Lover's card with a guardian angel. So spirit is really on the side of this connection. So we have, what else do we have for that Hierophant card? Ooh, a sexy, oh my gosh, you guys are powerful together. This Aries energy, there's so much fire in this relationship, Pisces, and so much nurturing. Look at that, the High Priestess. That is the consummate sort of handmaiden to the Empress. This is a passion that allows the two of you to move forward. So your relationship is passionate, nurturing, kind, sweet, very much all about having a grounded future with another person. The Death card says that there was a time when you thought you had a soulmate and you feel as though that soulmate was someone you'd spend your life with, and that isn't the case. So part of the Chaos card here that I see is the Death of an Old Soulmate card. You know, an old soulmate that you thought was yours, but spirit is saying this soulmate card is somebody from the past, and this soulmate card is somebody with the present, somebody who can, you're protected in this soulmate card. You were not protected over here from a lesson that you had to learn. And it's, you know, that's what soulmates are for, right? We learn lessons. But you've been through the mill. Now you're going to have the real deal, okay? So, look at you go from the Eight of Swords energy to the courage, the strength, the dignity. You have fire in your belly. This is the infinity symbol. You have met your match. Pisces, I'm so excited for you. It looks really like a beautiful energy that you'll walk side by side, that you'll enjoy your lives together. You're very dedicated to each other, but you do have, you know, you have more than one option, but I see you as really very much. You're going to match with the Emperor energy is what I'm seeing. So now I'm going to go to the next part of the readings, their thoughts, feelings, intentions, and actions. It may not connect to this reading, or it may. You will be the one who determines your story. Again, you know, these are general readings, so not every piece of the reading is going to fit. It can't. There's too many people in the collective watching. All right, so let's see what we have. Everybody's story is a little bit different. So let's see what we have here. See if we have. Okay, so thank you. I just want to ask everybody, how's Mercury retrograde treating you, and where are you from? I love to know where everybody's from. Where are you watching from around the globe? So let's see what we have. Thoughts, feelings, intentions, and actions of a love interest. Okay, so Pisces, we have cutting the deck here. Let's see what we have for you. We have, Knight of Wands energy. Ooh, look at that. Single, ready to mingle. Somebody, this is kind of hot. Oh, somebody with multiple options. That's funny. Okay, so, but we're looking at one person. So their thoughts, let's see what their thoughts are. That you are sexy, sexy, hotter than the hinges of hell. That you are fun, that you create laughter. That they have joyfulness with you. They want this relationship long term. Look at that. Their thought is that you are definitely the one for them. You're sexy, you're dynamic, you're fun, and you are a hard worker, that you really know how to create the coin, that you know how to have stability. In their heart space, they have a crush on you. They are in love with you. Look at that. We're going from the Page of Cups to the Knight of Cups. Pisces, that's your energy. The Ten of Wands says that the beauty of the situation currently is that your person has given up on their old baggage. They've left old baggage behind. That whatever chaos or, you know, whatever was in their lives, they've let go of it. They're really ready for love. They're open. They're sexy. Okay, and their intention. Honey, I'm home. Your person's coming in towards you. Look at that. Was it also in the earlier reading? They're coming right towards you. You may not be taking any action towards this person, but they are chasing you down, my friend. We have Pisces. Look at that. That's your energy, Pisces. So right now, your person doesn't know how you're going to respond to them. That's what I'm seeing. They don't know whether you're going to, you know, want them or not, but they definitely are fearful. They are nervous about coming forward, but they will come forward to see what's going on, to see what they can have with you. The outcome, nice actions. This person is very honest, very straightforward. The truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. They are walking out of a situation in which there was a storm. Now, for those of you who have had a fight with somebody, this can be a reconciliation. So take it as it resonates. It's possible. We have the Three of Wands. Your person is making a choice. They are actively making a choice that they can have their happiness with you. They're going to invest in this relationship. And again, I really like the two tens show that your person is fully healed from something that was very chaotic from them in the past, for them in the past. So that's your reading. Thank you so much, Pisces. Take care. Bye-bye. Sending you love from Chicago.